27. Amen. The book of Matthew 27. Hallelujah. And verse 52. Amen. 51. Thank you, Jesus. When you find it, can you please stand in holy reverence for the word of the Lord? Amen. Hallelujah. The book of Matthew 27 and verse 50 to 51. Jesus, when he had cried again with a loud voice, heal up the ghost, and behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from top to bottom. And he heard the quake and the rock rent. Father, I thank you for your word. It is not my word, O God, but it is your word today. Let your word go with power, and let your word go with clarity. In Jesus' name. And the church say, amen. You may be seated. Can I ask Brother Elizabeth Ainsley just to stand right here, amen, holding out, amen, the sheet for me. Hallelujah. The Lord.
Hallelujah.
Somebody worship him.
The
veil of the temple has been torn. Hallelujah. Come on, man, touch your neighbor. You know, I'm a participant preacher. I love the time you participate with me. Come on, say, neighbor. Hey, neighbor. The veil of the temple has been torn. You see, you don't understand it as yet. And that's the reason why you're not excited as yet. Because you don't know the significance of the veil. Hallelujah. Somebody worship the Lord. You see, having you know the significance of the veil, you'll be excited. Somebody worship him. Somebody bless the Lord. Somebody worship him. As in the veil of the temple, I'll be torn. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody magnify the Lord. Oh, as in the veil of the temple, I'll be torn. My brothers and sisters, the veil of the temple has been torn for you. Somebody worship the Lord. During the time of Jesus, the only temple in Jerusalem was the center of religious life. Hallelujah. Somebody praise him. I said, during the time of Jesus, the only temple in Jerusalem was the center of the Jewish religious life. The temple was a place where animal sacrifice, hallelujah, were carried out, and worship according to the law of Moses. Hallelujah. And it was followed faithfully. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody worship the Lord. According to Hebrews chapter 9 and 1 to 9, it tells us that in the temple the veil would separate the holy and the holiest. Hallelujah. The only place of God's presence. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody worship him. From the rest of the temple where man would dwell. This signified that man was separated from God. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody worship him. I said the veil is a symbol. The veil is a symbol that man was separated from God. The veil let us know that man was not worthy to go into the presence of a holy God. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody praise the Lord. Some a veil. Hallelujah. Some claim that the veil was about 6 inches. said that the veil was about 6 inches high, and they declared that the veil was about 4 inches thick. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody praise the Lord. The veil was a purple man, a purple veil. Somebody praise him. Somebody worship the Lord. As a veil had separated, hallelujah, man from God and God from man. As a result of this veil, the Bible said that even every year, the high priest would only alone permit, only high priest alone. Somebody praise the Lord. You see, every year, wanted to go in the presence of the Lord, but God said, I will not permit none to go in my presence. So they were only the high priest alone could enter through the veil. Anybody could go through the veil. For anybody go through the veil, I ain't worthy. You will be a dead person while the inside the temple. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody worship God. I said for many years, the children of Israel had to stay out of the outer court. They could not go into the most holy place. And while the priest was going into the holy place, they had to tie a chain at the priest's feet. And if the priest was worthy, while he entered into the most holy place, if he was worthy, he would be a dead person. While in there making a torment for Israel, the chain on his feet would shake and make noise. So while the chain would make not make noise, he tell that the priest is still alive. He tell that the priest is dead, but if the chain not make no noise, he tell that he was a dead person inside of the most holy place. So my way shook up. You're gonna come in fornication and go to church there. You're gonna have bad mind and go to church there. But you're gonna go into the presence of a holy God. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody praise him. So the priest have to make atonement. He have to come with a blood sacrifice to put on the altar of God. To put on the covenant seat. The mercy seat. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody give God glory. That the veil had been torn. You see, in those days, only the rich and Lord publicist alone could have afford salvation. For you have to have a dove or a turkey. You have to have a lamb to slay. The priest could not enter in here. To take on your mercy, to take on your mercy seat. Hallelujah. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody magnify the Lord. You see, the priest could not take it like that. He must have a sacrifice to lay down at the chair. He must bring a token. Hallelujah. Come on, help. He must bring a token. Put on the mercy seat. Something must have on the mercy seat. Some blood must have on the mercy seat. Hallelujah, but thank God. Somebody say thank God. That the veil has been torn. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody praise the Lord. With the Ramadan of supper. As brothers and sisters, the priest could only enter in the most holy place once per year. It was an hearts were here alone, the priest would enter in the presence of God. Once per year, the priest, hallelujah, would enter into the glory of a holy God. Somebody worship God. So the holy priest could enter in God's presence. He better consecrate himself. He better set apart. He better in and make sure that all is well. You have some preacher. They are preaching you. You have some people. They are seeking you. You have some. Somebody worship God.
Oh, priest,
know, I've done some things that weren't right. You know, I'm walking with the Lord. But you know, even have some secret sin in my life. You know, priest, last night I was watching pornography. You know, priest, last night I committed adultery and fornication. I don't think I want to bother with this marriage anymore. I'm serving the Lord, but I'm struggling with masturbation. I'm walking with the Lord, but every now and then I tell I am a thief, I'm a wicked. I don't think God will forgive me no more because I had sinned for too much forgiveness. I don't feel like we saved no more. Even though I'm going to church, I don't feel like I am Christian anymore. For the things that I am doing, nobody don't see me, pastor don't see me, elder don't see me, but my conscience, I don't have a priest. Can you imagine that you have to tell the priest everything? You have to confess your sin to the priest. And the priest would have to go to God and say, God, evangelist, but you tell me that I should lie and should kill such and such and you wicked. Oh God, have mercy and evangelist, but you. Oh God, have mercy and sister Melissa, see it. And the priest would plead on your behalf. And the priest would stand as a mediator between God and man. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody worship the Lord. But when he was upon the cross, Jesus cried out with a loud voice. Jesus said, it is finished. And the veil of the temple, the veil, I said, the veil of the temple was torn in two. The veil of the temple was torn. In other words, we have to go to the priest no more. In other words, we get shut in with God in a secret place. In other words, we can pray in the mirror. We can call upon God. Telephone from the glory. So that joyful divine, I can feel the power of the light. Somebody worship. I say, don't have to go to the priest anymore. You can now say, amazing grace. Oh, sweet the song that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I am found. What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of the crucified one. What can make me whole again? There is a fountain filled with blood, drawing from Emmanuel being. Oh, sinners can plunge beneath the rose hard. They killed and seen. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody worship me. Somebody praise him. Somebody praise him. Somebody praise him. So let me lay out with you, sister, bro. Bring out with the pastor. I can have a one-on-one with God. I don't want to go to the priest no more. But the feel of the temple, I'm in torn. I can enter the presence of God. I can have my own sacrifice. That's why the song I taught in the jam. We bring sacrifice and praise. When you go to the house of the Lord, when you come to church, you must go with a sacrifice. You must come with a worship. You must come with a hallelujah. You must come with a praise the Lord. You must come with a thank you, Jesus. We bring sacrifice and praise. When you go to the house of the Lord, and we offer unto him the sacrifices and praise. Somebody worship him. Somebody worship him. Somebody worship him. Come on, altars, we're on the river. Come on in, altars. Somebody worship him. Reveal, reveal, reveal. Tell them the veil, reveal, reveal. The veil of the temple, of torn. I said, if you not be torn, I said, if you not be torn, you can go to God in your own. You can say, God, it's me, oh Lord. Standing in the need of prayer. It's not my brother, it's not my sister. It's me, oh Lord. Standing in the need of prayer. So I can worship the Lord. Oh, come on, tell me, as a neighbor. You can pray on a prayer. Oh, you can talk to God in the night. You can talk to him in the night. You can talk to him in the morning. You can talk to him in the hours. Tell him about my troubles. He will understand. He will answer my time. So I will worship. The veil. I've been torn in a tomb. The veil will separate God, a holy God, from sinful man. God said, Adam and Eve, you have to come out of my presence. My sin cannot stay in my presence. So he tried them out over the garden. He said, no sin can stay where I am. But God, holy God, loves sinful man, but he is the sin. Somebody worship the Lord. Let me feel. I've been torn. According to the book of St. John, chapter 14, and verse 6. When the veil had been torn, Jesus cried out, I am the way! I am the truth! I am the life! No man cometh to God, but by me, Jesus. Jesus, I am the way. Jesus said, I am now the high priest. I now plea and intercede on the church behalf. Jesus is now making intercession on our behalf. He is now our high priest. So we can have a good talk with Jesus. Oh, somebody worship the Lord. In other words, according to the book of Hebrew, he said these things was a shadow, a foreshadow of the reality to come. Oh my God. So when Jesus cried out, it is finished. The religious system, according to Acts chapter 17 and verse 24, God said, I will no longer dwell in temple built with man's hand. Yes. Oh, God said, I will no longer dwell in temple built with hands of man. But God said, my law and my commandment, will I write it on their heart? Oh, somebody worship the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Somebody worship the Lord. God said, I'm building the temple system. Yeah. Ah, now at Jesus' time. Oh, now we can talk to Jesus anytime. God, the veil have been torn. So man can come to God. I came to Jesus as I was. We ring. Oh God. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody worship the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I know somebody is here. But because the veil have been torn, you get no call the bishop worried. I know somebody is here. My heart will hear it. Many of you take talk from people. Oh, but because they feel I've been torn. Ah, I don't want to say that I'm anymore. They feel I've been torn. But you and I, oh, we just sing and I'm lying. Talk to Jesus, man. Tell Jesus your weakness. He will understand your weakness. Oh, if I gossip by your weakness, tell him. If I back mine by your weakness, tell him. If I sex by your weakness, tell him. He can be acquainted with our griefs and sorrow. Somebody worship the Lord. Somebody worship him. the veil have been torn. Oh my God. What a thing. Man could enter the presence of the Lord. But Jesus said, it is finished. I pay the sin price for the human race. Just as I am, do you just see? Just as I am. Oh, my verse one. The Lord hands are not short, so he cannot reach you. The Lord ears are not deaf, so he cannot hear you. But your iniquity and your sins have separated the Holy God from you. Oh God, sins are dangerous things. Sin separate man from God. Sin make man not like church. Sin make man not want to praise God. Sin is a dangerous thing. Oh, but the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Christ Jesus. For me, I've been torn for something today. I don't ask the whole church just to walk up one to the other. We are walking into something new. Let's go.